Well, compared to Walters, where there was a lot of stripe rust and Septoria leaf blotch, up here at Stillwater, we're seeing much more powdery mildew.
Give us an example of what's in this plot.
Okay. This is my foliar fungicide trial, and if you look at it at the top, in the upper foliage, it just looks nice and pretty and green with the heads coming out and some anthers coming out of there. But if you look down low into some of the trial, into some of the plots, you'll see that there's a lot of powdery mildew down low, and that's been the case this whole last month up here around Stillwater and around much of the rest of the state as well. The powdery mildew down low, it has worked its way up to the leaf right underneath the flag here, and so it's sapping nutrients and water out of those leaves and not allowing the leaves to produce the nutrients for the plant and to fill the grain as that approaches more. That lower canopy will tend to die off a lot earlier since it has those powdery mildew infections. This would be a plot that had an early application of fungicide on it close to a month ago. And if you do the same thing here and pull back the upper leaves, you see very little powdery mildew down low on these plants. And that's one of the strategies for controlling powdery mildew. Of course, you can have resistant varieties, but chemicals will also control this. But this is a good example where that chemical needs to go on a lot earlier than it would for the rust to control the powdery mildew. The idea for the fungicides with this is that to control that powdery mildew down low, and I have some data that shows that those early infections with powdery mildew, especially if it gets up into the mid and upper canopy, can reduce yield significantly. And so to control those, it would have to be an early fungicide application. Now, I had mentioned previously that there are some changes in the labeling of the fungicides. There's a group of fungicides that can be put on up through flowering when flowering is over. Those can be put on through 10.5.4, which is the end of flowering. There's another group of fungicides that is related to flowering itself. They can only be put on through when flowering has occurred, and they have to be on before flowering really starts. And then there's another group that has a combination of those two things. Some of them have a date related to flowering, but they also have what's called a pre-harvest interval, meaning that they can go on up to, there has to be 30 days in some cases elapsed between the fungicide application and when you harvest. So the key point to that is to be sure to look closely at the label to make sure that you're using the fungicide in accordance with the label and not going off label in terms of an application.
Okay, Bob, thanks a lot. We'll see you again soon.